Hello, everyone. So sorry. It's so dark here today. That doesn't help anything. Hold on. I lower this. Is this better? No, it's worse. I look horrible. That's better. I think that's doable. Hello, everyone. Welcome to the Welcome to the program. It is dark. I don't think it's blustery. I don't know. Do you need snow for it to be blustery? But it makes you want to sit inside. It's dark out, and it makes it feel cold. It makes you want to sit inside and have a nice, hearty soup or a stew or some chicken and dumplings, some good old home cooking, that kind of thing. Hello, everyone. Lovely to see you. My name is RJ, if you're not familiar. And today I will be making coffee. And I'm also wearing this fine underwear. This is from the Armani collection I was so generously gifted for my birthday. It was some hot stuff. This is a comic book pattern. Things say pow, zap, all that kind of bang. That fun kind of thing. Wasn't really a fan of comics, yet here we are. I do enjoy the pattern, and that's the important thing. There are people in the chat already. I will try to get through it as fiduciously as possible. Please bear with me. Al, can't wait for the stream to start. Well, today's your lucky day. Ty said, the comic book design, good choice. Happy Sunday, RJ. I hope you had a good morning. That well-wishing increases our intimacy. It makes me feel uncomfortable. Karen said, good evening. How are you all today? Well, hi, if you paid her tax by liking the video. Thank you. Richard said, good day. Have a great day, mate. Death Knight said, oh, snap, RJ Sunday again. Just missed Jessamine. Sadly enough, it's a real 1-2 combo. Al said, just saw RJ on J Duke's stream. Excited to see RJ make coffee in his underwear. Yeah, it's going to be a hoot. Leo said, RJ, if I send you $400 and ask you out on a date, will you send me a 47-second rejection video? I'll do it for $250. Jack says, good day, friends. Clint said, hello again, RJ. And now that's one cool-looking underwear. I think you can just say that's cool-looking underwear. Underwear, like pants, are one of those things that are plural, even in the singular. You know? That's one cool-looking underwear. You just say, that's cool-looking underwear. That's one great pants. Bill says, morning, RJ and everyone. Hope you're having a wonderful Sunday. And a wonderful turquoise tribute from Bill. He said, I know David Arquette would say, don't encourage RJ. As you may be aware, I was tweeting David all morning because his sleep schedule has been disrupted by his own erratic life. And he's up. He's in L.A. right now. So he was up tweeting me at 3 o'clock in the morning. And it was 6 o'clock in the morning for me. And he told us we got rejected by Late Night with Seth Meyers. So I'm going to blame that squarely on David because he's supposed to be the one with the contacts. And Seth, if you're interested, I will be available to come on the program solo. And we can talk about a wide variety of things. But Bill said, why don't we hear September song by Frank Sinatra, please and thank you. Well, Bill, it's one of my favorites. Here we go. Do you remember September? Today. September. Do you remember? September. That was a wonderful September song by Frank Sinatra. And it was in his swinging years. He was very youthful. And it was one of my favorite songs. I hope that works for you, Bill. Jack said, starting early, you love to see it. I guess you do. Oh, there's way more people in the chat now. Dear Lord, I got to get to work. Clint said, I hope David's joining us. Lord, who knows? Jack said, well, what else you got to do on a Sunday? Morning, Mr. City. Hunter R said, stove lighting, yes. Nail said, good morning, everyone. Clarence said, hi, RJ. I made it back to New York for my milestone year to continue celebrating, buddy. Well, yes, I will continue celebrating if you do. Jessamine Duke said, this is mood lighting. I don't know what the mood is. It's yellow. This is horrible lighting. I got to get it changed. Jessamine Duke likes chicken and dumplings. Well, good for you. Nail said, hi, I'm good. I'm hoping you are too. Val said, good morning, Bills. And Nail telling you, everyone's just saying hi. So we can see. Santiago Cabral says, hi, love from Argentina. Now, is Santiago calling me love, saying hi, love, or say hi, comma, love from Argentina? Really need to work on the punctuation, but thank you. And then Richard said, hola, Argentina. NPDMD say good morning, RJ. Al say good evening to Karen. Nails wants to know if David's going to join us or is he going back to bed? Who knows? He'll be sleeping intermittently throughout the day. Richard said, RJ, have you visited Australia? Not that you can now anyway. No, I haven't. I don't think I want to because there's a lot of weird creatures there that are not my bag. And I'm not quite interested in getting to know them on a personal level. I've seen them in books and things, and that seems to be enough for me. Steven said, in keep with a wonderful mint tribute, in keeping with the comic book theme, I think you should sing the classic Wonder Woman theme from 1975. Oh, I love that theme. I love it. I love it. One of my favorites, Linda Carter. Big fan of the Wonder Woman theme. Here we go. Brum, dun, 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 da. Do you wonder? Da, 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 da. Do you wonder? Da, 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 da. Because I wonder da, 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 where that woman is. Da, 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 da. Do you wonder? Da, 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 da. Do you wonder? Da, 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 da. Because I wonder da, 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 where that woman is. Da, 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 da. My, what an outfit. Da, da, da. My, what a lasso. Da, da, da. A nice pair of boots. Da, 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 da. And a headband, too. Da, 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 da. Do you wonder? Da, 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 da. Do you wonder? Da, 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 da. Because I wonder da, 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 who that woman is. Da, 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 da. Wonder Woman. It was the end. That was a theme from the classic 1975 Wonder Woman. Certainly one of my favorites. Bill said it worked for me. He loves any version of September Song. And you'll say, good morning, my sexy sweetheart. Dear Lord, is that directed to me? I'm so glad I could see your wonderful smile today. I hope you're enjoying the long weekend. It is a long weekend. Monday will be the long portion. So this is really now a Saturday to me. So maybe I should have done this tomorrow. Danny said, I'm working on my car. But RJ's lovely rendition of September Song is killing me. You know, back in the day, fellas working on their cars, maybe put a little White Snake on the radio, you know, and they'd have those calendars with those voluptuous women. But now, you know, society's changed and all you need to do is put me on and I'll cover all your bases. Charles Dempsey Brown said, did you not take time to wash the sleepy out of your eyes? Another cunning insult by the refusing to have a profile picture of his face, Charles Dempsey Brown. Panto's grandma said, it's more pinkish from where I'm watching. It's very Moulin Rouge, complete with the musical numbers. Thank you. I'll take it. That's what I'll tell you. Al said, RJ, are you the AWA champion? No, but I'm signed with them and a big fan of Vern, and that's my home. That's where I want to be right now. I just actually re-signed every 2 weeks. Short contracts, but that keeps you on your toes, keeps you competitive, and maybe one day, if I'm lucky enough, I'll be offered a three-month contract, and then I'll get the title shot. Eric said, RJ, recording remotely from a crypt today. It's so dark outside. It really looks like nightfall, and it's rainy, and it's a hot, chubby rain. Santiago said, he did forget the comma there. I forgive you. It's so sweet of you. Danny loves Wonder Woman. Jack said, oh, I dug Linda in her voice acting role in Fallout 4. It's an obscure video game reference. Hunter said, Gal Gadot is going to punch you in the face for this song. That's fine. Nail said, yes, this is why we are here. This is good stuff. My, what a lasso. Ty said, him being his own backing sound effect is my absolute favorite. Pantyless Grandma said, more songs should end with the end. Clint said, amazing theme song, loving the 1970s. Jack said, wait, I got it. This is RJ Before Light. Leo said, Hunter, Gal Gadot can't get angry at anyone for singing Wonder Woman. Linda Carter would be proud. Clint said, hey, RJ, did you close your curtain? No, it's incredibly dark outside, and I'm having issues with maybe if I. Will this help? Does this make the world better? This help anyone? It's just now so bright behind me. Maybe I have. If I just dim this, I think that's better. The issue is that it makes it so bright behind me, and it's still not on my face, though. I need to light my face. I look ridiculous. Neil said, if you tell Charles to stop, he blocks you, people in the chat, if you don't want to see things. Charles, don't block people. That's very sad. Jessamine said, WTF. Fallout 4 is not obscure. Okay, gamer. I'm playing the hot games. I played Streets of Rage last night, and it was a hoot. Eric said, hot chubby rain. That was my name in high school, was my nickname. Bill said, speaking of Crypt, are there any horror fans here? The great Wilford Brimley passed. RJ, did you love his movie, The Thing? I mean, I really wouldn't call it his movie. He was more of a cocoon guy to me. And I was just telling my friend this morning, there's actually a sequel to the movie Cocoon with pretty much all of the original cast called Cocoon: The Return. Hunter said, Fortnite is an obscure video game, and that's a quote attributed to me. Well, I think Linda Carter doing a voice for it. Not Fortnite, Fallout. Get it together. That literally misquoted by Hunter. Leo said, who is the hot woman wearing the gold in the 2009 promo you did by the pool while in those blue Music Note trunks? It was literally a friend of a friend who was like, okay, sure. Never saw her again. Nice gal. Neil said, what, has no idea that people are still watching that video for sure. Neil said, what mug are you using today? Did I miss it? What about a coaster? Well, the mug I'm using today, and let's get pressing. I wanted to take a little time to enjoy the view, so I brought out this Huckleberry with Whoopi and this cactus-holding woman. I believe this is the Sunny Hostin here and Joy and the other woman. And her dog, Joy's dog. And let's get pressing. As you know, I am making cold brew. And I've already made it. I made this yesterday morning. I don't have a coaster here because this is a countertop. If it was a table or something, if I'm sitting in a chair, I would certainly have a coaster. But the coasters I use on After Dark, you'll have to join me on Wednesdays to see them. Let's give it a good. Preston, let's think about the long weekend and what we like about our lives and what we want to keep and what we don't like and what we want to improve and alter and better in this ever-flowing, in this French press that we call life. There we are. There, very good. And yes, if you are just joining us, I got these fun comic book things on Pow, Zop, Bang, Zoom. You know, it's a real hoot. Neil said, I like that OK Gamer on YouTube, Twitter, and shout OK Gamer if I see it. That's what I do for fun. Painless Grammar said, we went from the crypt to the pearly gates, which makes sense. RJ is who I expect to see there bouncing dorks. Get out, pal. You stole a protein bar from a health food store, and it's no good. We can't have you. Nicholas said, I just let my cat outside and it started to pour. It being ridiculous. Hunter said, it's now quoting me saying, Halo is an obscure video game. And I think it is. I certainly never played it. Jordan said, good morning, darling. Good morning to you. Fine use of my emoji. Jack said, yes, let's keep talking about the Fallout franchise. It's my personal favorite gaming franchise. Well, you know, at the beginning, in the cut screen, when that thing opens and everyone falls out. It is a trip. It's an experience. Al loves me saying Huckleberry. Jessamine says, Jack, what's your favorite game in the series and why is it Fallout New Vegas? Why are you guys having this? Take this offline. Jack said, why it is Fallout New Vegas? Thank you for asking. This seems like a scheme. Do you people work with the Fallout people? Neil said, Danny, then Danhausen with the coasters. Angel said, I would buy a set of RJ coasters. When people come over for wrestling pay-per-views, I will be able to show them off. Well, I will say I'm getting there. In the meantime, I do have my mug at prowrestlingtees.com/RJCity if you're all interested ever. It's the only mug with my mug on it. Hunter said, Justin Duke, someone gifted me New Vegas on Steam a few years ago, and I never touched it because I don't like to have fun. That's a man after my own heart. Angel said, I need a new French press. Well, get one. What the hell are you waiting for? Can I order it on Amazon or something? Or anyway, you can go to just to the store. They have them at the store. Jack said, indeed, it's what every damn open world art. Well, we got to talk about video games here. I wanted to talk about Mary Jo Payton. Neil's New York said, nothing needs improving from 9:30 to 10:30 a.m. on a Sunday. Rest of the week, meh. Angel said, I have a dress like your underwear. Well, maybe we should swap. I'll wear the dress. I think that'll be fun. I've certainly got the legs for it. Jasmine said, well, that makes sense, Hunter. And we continue this conversation I'm not a part of. Hunter said, everyone ignore RJ now and the chatter's calling him sexy. This is now a Jasmine Duke video game chat. What a real ignorant takeover. Leo said, will Vern Gagne wrestle Cody for the All Elite Wrestling Turner Network Television Championship? I am actually the PBS champion. Richard said, Doom was great. I assume you're referring to the obscure WCW tag team. Hunter said, Super Mario Sunshine is an obscure video game. Compared to Super Mario 3, Super Mario Sunshine is an obscure video game. Jasmine said, cut screen made me cringe all over. I love when they go, you're playing a game, and it stops, and they go, cut, and they do these little scenes. And they have the writing at the bottom. And they say, okay, back to the game. Nail said, my video game knowledge is only sometimes I watch wrestlers play video game. That's fair. Eric said, would you do a burger towel? It sounds like some sort of sexual maneuver. Perhaps at an orgy, one that after somebody got broken, tore some cartilage. Nobody does that maneuver anymore. But I'd be interested in learning about it. Bill said, RJ is more hip than Fallout. He plays the Three Stooges. Makes them more hip in my eyes. Yeah, and I play other hip video games like, WrestleFest. I'm doing that WrestleFest series now. On my channel next Wednesday, I play as Demolition Smash. Wait till you see the cutscenes on that one. Al said, can't wait for August 4th to order my J. Duke and RJ mugs, which reminds me, if you do want to buy a shirt or a mug, hang on to your money for two more days. There's a sale that starts August 4th. And then indulge and get a nasty email from me. Aaron says, RJ for Buzzer Champ. I love Buzzer so much. You know, because remember like the Game Show Network and they would play old game shows, but then they would also try to do new ones, like new versions of old ones and like new ones. There was a really terrifying game called The Inquisition that I remember. And then someone said, you know what? You know what? No. We need a channel just for the old games. Richard said, RJ, what was the worst bump you took? You know what was really painful? Two of them that were extraordinarily stupid. It's never the big ones because you really prepare yourself for them and you wouldn't do them if they were that dangerous. It's the sleeper ones where you don't think they're going to hurt that much and they hurt a lot. There's two times I had to bump on things that were horrible ideas. One time I wrestled Adam Rose, and after the match, he poured out a bag of ring pops, and he gave me a rock bottom onto the ring pops. And those hurt so much because they're plastic, and they're thick. They're like this big, and they're, oh, my God. It was so, and I was just like, I remember thinking, this will be fun, and I remember hitting and immediately going, that was like, why didn't I calculate this in my head at all? And then the other one was I was doing a Christmas show, Every Time I Die, that band, Andy Williams or whatever his name is, the Butcher and the Blade guy, had a Christmas show, and it was me against Gregory Iron and Dick Justice in a Christmas death match. And they did the old Home Alone Hot Wheels routine where they put Hot Wheels on the ring, and I tried to chase him, and I slipped and fell on the Hot Wheels, and that also hurt a lot for pretty much the exact same reason. So you thought I would learn perhaps from the ring pop fiasco. But I did not. Nail said, I'm in the mood to watch Young Frankenstein today. Anyone know where it would be online? It's not on Netflix. That's a shame. Or any Mel Brooks? Maybe it's not on Amazon. Red Dog said, I want to see Arn Anderson finally show up on Tosh.0 whenever that show comes back. I'm so not interested in Tosh. Hunter said, but he does look good for 57. Oh, he's talking about me. Yes, I do. Lost Shadow said, I've been summoned. Bill said, speaking of games, do you know there's a Vern Gagne wrestling board game from the 1950s? We will have to get Nug to find it for you. I'll post a picture later of the game. I have heard of the game. Nug and I are trying to find, there's a Mil Mascaris board game, which seems even more mysterious. Nug does have a bunch of old wrestling games. I really have to go play them. Leo said, which wrestler would you most like to wrestle in a Trading Places match? A match where you have to dress as your opponent. And who would you least like a Trading Places match with? Now I'm just thinking of the way people dress that I think is fun. Maybe like a Jushin Liger. I want that whole outfit. And even more than that, I really want to just see him in my outfit. That's how you get people. That's a psychological advantage. That's, even though I'd be incredibly hot and sweaty and I wouldn't be able to see. I had that wig and that hair and I couldn't breathe. So, you know, Jushin Thunder Liger is the person I most want to wrestle in that match and the person I also least want to wrestle in that match. Hunter said, which wrestler would you... Oh, well, we did this already. Oh, no. Sorry. Which wrestler would you most like to do the show Trading Places with where you have to redo their living room? Tommy Dreamer. I'd be interested in seeing what he has on his mantle. Probably a lot of barbed wire and track pants. Val said, big same. I love Buzzer. Sale of the Century, Match Game, Hollywood Square, Supermarket Sweep, Concentration. Classics. One of my favorites. I mean, obviously you love Match Game and Family Feud and whatever. I loved Card Sharks. Big fan. Big fan of Card Sharks. Where are we? Are we losing here? Video of RJ and his mom playing the board game. What board game? Al said, RJ, if a famous actor's ghost could haunt you, who would you want to haunt you? Oh, Dom DeLuise. That would be so much fun. That would, hey, Dom, that kind of thing in the middle of the night. Oh, don't mind me. I'm just going to get a piece of cake. Jordan Patrick said, Tosh sucks. In regards to Young Frankenstein, if you look it up on IMDb, it should show you some options to stream it. Very good idea. Stephen Free said, use the website Just Watch, Snails. You can type in a movie or TV show, and it will tell you where it's streaming. Hunter said, RJ versus Danhausen, where RJ has to imitate Danhausen to the point where he annoys himself. Charles Dempsey Brown said, I'm trying to compliment you now. Even with sleep in your eyes, you're younger and more handsome than me, sir. Honestly, though, LOL. You know what I really don't like is that you put the space after you put an exclamation mark. That's just poor form. Bill said, RJ, you could pull off Repo Man in a Trading Places match. Repo Man. Dun, 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 dun. It's a great song. They literally just said his name over the song. That was it. That's how little he had to do. Panzo's grandma said there's a super legal copy of Young Frankenstein on YouTube and also a taping of the stage version, which I haven't seen. Ooh, Steven said it's streaming on Stars. I'm a streaming information service. You come into the chat, you type a movie you want, and people will write where it's available. Leo said, which wrestler would you most like to wrestle in a gravy bowl match? Well, I think it's really disgusting. Gravy is not remotely alluring to me at all, but I would say Francine. Al Valentia said, if they remake Perfect Strangers TV show, you would be perfect for that show. Jeez, well, call the network, Al. Hunter said, RJ versus Danhausen in a lingerie pillow fight, paddle on a pole, and a swimming pool match. We've had it before, but there were no cameras around. Nail said, everyone here is so helpful. Thank you. Red Dog said, I want Laurel and Hardy to haunt me. And then they're in the afterlife. And he says, what another fine mess you've gotten us into. Nail said, did you watch the pay-per-view last night? Yes, I did. And it was Bowling with Celebrities. It was one of my favorite pay-per-views. And I'll tell you something. That Pierce Brosnan has a mean hook shot. Let's get pouring, shall we? Let's do a little test and see where we're at in terms of sweetness. It's a little bitter. We're going to do some bulletproof. Jordan said, you're a modern-day Kramer with movie phone. Do you remember looking in the newspapers to see when a movie was playing? What a fucking... If you wanted to see a movie, you had to really want to go see it. He did not make it easy. Val said, gravy is gross. It's thick meat juice, which is also another name I had in high school. Leo said, which wrestler would you most enjoy defeating in a hair versus hair match? Ooh, Steve Austin, because he'll be like, "Ah, I don't have any hair," and I'll be like, "Ah, I'm shaving your goatee," and then I was like, "What the fuck?" And then I'll look so weird with a goatee, without a goatee. Dear Lord, I blew that. Neil said, "American gravy is different than British gravy. There's also white gravy, apparently. It's a whole thing." Bill said, "Speaking of gravy, I love your tribute to Dom DeLuise." Yes, I did an episode of Good, Bad, the Unknown on Dom DeLuise. Where did you first discover him? I know I want to try his cooking. I will say, and who knows where I first discovered him, probably timeline-wise, I probably first saw him hosting Candid Camera, which he hosted after Alan Funt. And then my grandmother used to have this cookbook called Eat This, and it was a Dom DeLuise book, and I had it. She ended up giving it to me because I would not stop talking about it. Where else did I see him? Inadvertently, I heard him in things like All Dogs Go to Heaven and Five Will Goes West. And one of the first movies I distinctly remember him in is Haunted Honeymoon. Neil said, "I would love to be haunted by Elvis." Yeah, but what if it's old Elvis, Neil? Do you ever think about that? And he's just wheezing around the room and making poor, grandiose financial decisions. Brady said, "Has Nick Gage ever recruited you to the MDK gang?" You have to fill out a form. It's really a whole thing. Pantelis Grandma said, "Would you rather hold a seance with the ghosts of Hollywood stars or the ghosts of wrestlers?" Well, I don't want the room turned over, so I'm going to pick ghosts of Hollywood stars 1,000 times over. Leo said, "What about loser has to grow a neck beard match?" Is that what this is? Because I may have lost. Hunter said, "RJ versus Danhausen and an eye for an eye at the Wyatt compound match. I want to go to the Hyatt compound. We just hang out in a suite, have a little sleepover." Nicholas said, "I also have that cookbook, RJ. I love it so much." Leo said, "Have you met Nick Gage? Is he scary?" No and yes. Karen said, "Later, everyone. God bless you, Karen." Jessamine said, "Five Will Goes West is one of my favorites, but like, of course it is. Like a mouse becoming a cowboy sounds like a plot you would be deeply interested in. I'm gonna look and see if there are any Fievel video games. I don't know if the movie was successful enough to warrant a video game." Neil said, "Okay, now I want to watch Haunted Honeymoon." It's not that good. Jordan said, "Robin Hood Men in Tights. That was my first Dom DeLuise experience that I remember." That's very much towards the end of his run, and I often forget that he's in it. Same with Richard Lewis. Neil said, "There are no cats in American, and the streets are paved with cheese." I guess we're quoting the movie. Leo said, "Have you heard of the Frasier cookbook?" No, I haven't, although I don't know what to do with tossed salad and scrambled eggs, and I assume that's like the first recipe. And then they'll probably have like a dad's beer-soaked chicken or something. Bulldog's pot roast. Maris's unseen dishes. I will look up this cookbook though. Nail said, "These eye for an eye matches can piss off." I love how you censor the eye in piss because this is a family show. Jessamine, were you in the audience for that one? I don't know if she was. She was in the peanut gallery. Ty said, "RJ just throwing shade at everyone today. Kind of what I do because it's so dark here." Nail said, "Ty, I think it's because there's no sunshine. He's cranky." Stokely said, "Silence of the Hams is a good Dom DeLuise movie." Jessamine said, "There's a Land Before Time video game." God, that was so. They were like, "Let's do Bambi with dinosaurs." It was so boring and so sad and so unfunny. Oh my God, I hated it so much. Jordan said, "What's with all the Nick Gage questions? Your tag partner for life and death is 440H. I'm not familiar with. Orrin Hatch. I'm a big fan of." Hunter said, "RJ strikes back at the chat day after we give him so much shit for pretty much nothing." Jack said, "My first experience with Dom DeLuise." Yes, let's all share our first experiences with Dom DeLuise. "Was him playing Guilt on Amazing Stories." Oh, I have not seen that, and I should. My, I loved. There's an episode, I think, of Tales of from the Crypt with Don Rickles. I think it's Tales from the Crypt. Nail said, "Land Before Time is Sad. In real life, too, didn't someone die? Well, people are dying all the time, Nails. Leo said, strangely, there's no toast salad and scrambled eggs recipe, but there is a Martin candy bar and an ice cream recipe and a bulldog bacon and cheese croissant recipe. Yeah, that seems like him. Jessamine said, she's crushed, and then used the Andre the Giant emoji to infer that perhaps Andre is the one crushing her. Val said, I hated Land Before Time. Sad and boring is about right. Land Before Time 37. We're still here. You'd think they would end. You know you have Elvis in the house when you keep finding exotic new sandwiches in the kitchen. The legend has it is that he died, you know, on the toilet with a fried peanut butter and jelly sandwich. And I think someone must have bought him a fryer for Christmas. And he was just frying around. When you have access to a full fryer, that's what I would do too, to be honest with you. Revenge Be Craig 5 said, if David Arquette can't get you a part in Scream 5, first of all, I just want to say, I'm even amazed that David got a part in Scream 5. Do you think you can get Courtney Cox to get you in Scream 5? Well, Courtney and I have a bit of a grudge. She made me a bad cappuccino, and I did not like it. And she told me when I see her again, she'll make me a new one. So I got to scratch that off the list. Before we get into movies and acting and things of that nature, I need a cappuccino. Ty said, Land Before Time crushed me as a child. I think I've seen half of the movies once and refused to ever watch it. You know what else sucked? Fern Gully. Red Dog said, I like Dom and Old Dogs Go to Heaven. Nail said, did Andre sit on people like Earthquake did? But yeah, that was kind of his finisher, and then he became tired of it. Steven said, the little girl who played Ducky was killed by her father. Holy shit. This took a sudden turn. Leo said, what if CZW released a cookbook? Cage of Death by Chocolate. Bill said, Robin Hood Men in Tights was hilarious. Any Mel Brooks movies are awesome. I watched Dom do a duet last night with Dean Martin. So funny. The best part about the Dean Martin variety show is that he never wanted to rehearse, so he would go golfing while everyone was writing and rehearsing. And then most of the time in the show and scenes you see from the show, he's reading all of this for the first time. Neil said, what a happy morning. Hunter said, well, damn, I shouldn't have typed that now seeing Steven's message. Bad timing. That's for sure. Shame on you, Hunter. Stokely said, Don Rickles was a ventriloquist on Tales from the Crypt. His hand was a monster or something. That was it. Clint said, hey, RJ, I got to ask, if you were paid as a heel, would you do that or try something else to get paid? What? I'm paid as a heel. There are so many people not buying my merchandise right now. It's going incredibly, incredibly well. Exactly as the gods of wrestling have wanted. Steven said, I used to have peanut butter, banana, and mayo sandwiches. Well, that's because you didn't have a well-stocked fridge, Steven. Revenge said, lie and say it was a really good cappuccino after all. Panther's grandma said, my first Dom DeLuise experience was probably Cannonball Run. That's for a lot of people, too. He was very, very friendly with Burt Reynolds, and Burt Reynolds was also good friends with Charles Nelson Reilly. They ran this little acting school together, and I think they appeared together either on an episode of Sally, Jesse, Raphael, or Vicky. Vicky Lawrence's talk show. Vicky with an exclamation mark, of course, because that's what a dynamo she is. Here we go. Came in, everyone. There we are. That's better. We're getting this going. It's a real pleasant sound. That's enough. I'm going to put two stevia in because it was just so gosh darn bitter. Did you ever see old men do this? Because they beat the shit out of the sugar before they open it. It's a real power play. It's a real alpha male thing to just abuse a pack of sugar. Oh, Lord. I didn't beat it up enough. And look, it's all sitting at the top like this, like some sort of cappuccino. Okay, whatever. We'll leave it. We're going to get through it. We're going to drink it. Bill said, Marty. Jack said, real quick, is it just me? Or do we have here in the chat room to be more of a distraction than anything else today? I think it's just you. I'm enjoying it. It's very sweet of you. And sometimes people are in the right mood collectively. We're going to go with the flow, like the French press. That's what I was alluding to earlier, the flow of life. Neil said, Ty, this website called Does the Dog Die? That will warn you without spoilers if animals die or get into mild peril in movies. The shame is you type in My Girl and they're like, nope, everything's fine in this one. And then you watch it. And then Macaulay Culkin dies and you're crying all over again. Revenge said, if all dogs go to heaven, does that mean that all cats go to hell? No, because I don't think they believe in an afterlife. They're just like, this is it. We're good. Steven said, indeed, it was not a well-stocked fridge. Pantelous Grandma said, wait, Dom was in the Best Little Whorehouse? How do I not remember that? You need some rewatching to do. Hunter said, I'm making money off RJ being a heel too by making knockoff RJ City mugs by means of Sharpie drawings and then selling said mugs from the back alley of my apartment building because it's the only bootleg mug with my mug on it. The cats were bad guys. Oh, that was true. Stokely said, do the horse, which is, of course, from the wonderful Bobby Fish. And he did Bobby did like this version, but the horse that I'm most, I don't know how he did it. This is very Bobby McFerrin of me to do, but the horse I do. Is that, I can do it the other way. Not as well. The snap here is weird. My pinky goes up. No, nope, terrible. That hurts. I don't know how Bobby Fish does it. But please continue to tweet Bobby Fish and ask him to do the horse. Simon said, do you know when the kick shirt will return? I am going to follow up on it. The problem, I believe, is that they no longer were stocking. It's not that they were no longer stocking. They ran out of the actual mint green shirts that they were on. So they basically pulled the shirt because they didn't have, they pulled the design because they didn't have the shirt to print it on. But that I will follow up with them after this. Thank you for reminding me, Simon. You know what made me so happy? Some guy is a fan of mine, bought it for a guy who's not a wrestling fan at all. He's just a guy, a real big kitsch guy, and he loved it. That made me so happy. It's such a concerted segment of people that are intentionally in bad taste, and it makes me so happy. Hunter said, I love Stevia, but working at Starbucks, people will request literally 10 packs of Stevia in keto drinks. And I'm like, that's disgusting. Yeah, because they're trying to compensate because it's probably not a sustainable diet. I love, in Starbucks now, there's no drink station. You know the station with the cream and the sugar and the sticks and all that shit? Sometimes there's honey, the cocoa powder. Not there anymore, which sucks because every time I walked in there, I would grab like 20 packs of Stevia, just stuff them in my pockets and leave. It's a real shame. Stike said, Stephen Pike said, do you have a move called the French press? Well, not right now because I haven't wrestled. But maybe when I come back, we'll think of something. Neil said, when you have 9 lives, you can't be bothered with an afterlife. Yes, it's exhausting. Bill said, you missed my Marty comment. I said, if we need you in any, what? In any time in the future, we will need you in an eye for eye match with Marty Feldman. Mel Brooks. Producing the match. Actually, I would much rather wrestle Sammy Davis Jr. in an eye for an eye match. That would be a good finish. Ring said, Chromatica or Folklore? I'm a Folklore man. I like getting out in the town and hearing what people are saying, hearing about the lore, getting together with the folks and hearing some good old-fashioned lore. Leo said, if you do a podcast, will you have Donald Trump Jr. on like a certain other wrestler did? If I did, he would not get a word in. Let me put it that way. Neil said, Bobby Fish joined Cameo. We could actually get him to do the horse. Oh my God, please. Please someone order a Cameo from Bobby and just say, Bobby, do the horse. He'll do it. Ty said, RJ is just slapping his body. Steven said, don't worry, be horsey. Neil said, RJ's horse is more like a Kamala. Yes, it is. It is. I want to paint a moon on my belly. Hunter said, RJ slapping himself all over his body is living Charles' dream, as opposed to dead Charles' dream. Val said, thanks, Nails. Hate that movie, too. I really don't like sad movies that much. Tom said, I always thought of your version of the horse as Curly from the Three Stooges thing. Didn't even occur to me. It sounded like a horse. Oh, yeah, he did. He did that kind of thing. What did Shemp do? Not that much. Oh. What's an impression of Shemp? Steven said, just get a coffee at Cumberland Farms. Richard said, when you order a coffee and they ask for your name, do you say RJ City? You know what? Most of the time I tell people my name is Doug because it's my fucking fantasy and they do what I want. And this one time I was ordering, not at a Starbucks, but at another restaurant that has a similar system. And they said, and your name is? And I said, Doug. And the girl said, are you sure your name is Doug? I was like, yeah. She's like, I think your name is RJ. And I went to high school with her sister and she knew who I was. So, and then I had to explain, like, look, this is my little sick fantasy. It's a private thing. I'm by myself. I like to, the best part, like telling someone your name is Doug is one thing, but the best is like waiting for 5 minutes and then, because you got to be on edge. You got to be ready. You can't fuck it up because this is your new name now. I'll be like, Doug, and you gotta go, yep, that's the best. Yep, just answering, like telling the world, taking a transaction as Doug. Feels like you're robbing a bank in a sense. This other time we were at Starbucks. I was at Starbucks with my father. And they said to me, and what's your name? And I said, Simon. And I do it, I'm not like, oh, my name is Batman. Like, I don't try to make a joke out of it. I try to make it, like, as real as possible because it's funny to me. I said, Simon. And they looked at my father and said, and what's your name? And he went, Simeon. Now, there's multiple things wrong with that. First of all, when somebody asks you what your name is, the first thing to come out of your mouth should not be, you shouldn't have to think about what your name is. Number two, he looked up as if he was wondering, like, oh, I got to come up with something too. Where could it be? As if it was up there. And then number three, he didn't even really think of a name because I said Simon. And clearly by him saying Simeon meant that he was going to say Simon too. His only option was, and then realized he couldn't. So it came out Simeon. Now what's more stupid? Me being just Simon in my own life, my own little world, or me being Simon, and my father's name is Simeon, and I'm getting a coffee with him. Ruined the whole thing, and I can never go to that Starbucks again. Oh, Clint said, okay, RJ, bye now. I need to work in our home. Yes, it's our home. Clint and I bought a bungalow together. Thank you, Clint. You're doing great work. Ty said, so you're mad you have to actually buy your own Stevia now. Yeah, I'm pretty pissed. Bill said, oh, I'm losing. You know, that's the problem telling a story for so long. That I'm like, where did everyone? I'll get back there. I lose the chat. The chat like loads and then it's a whole thing. RJ stealing Stevia packets from Starbucks is stopping me from getting the $25 hour wage that I deserve because of a loss in the company. Let me tell you something. I give them a lot more money than they deserve. You guys are breaking even. Bill said, I think we can now classify you as more as the best all-round entertainer there is today, not just a wrestler anymore. I really wasn't a wrestler when I was a wrestler. You're too well-rounded. I'm very round, except for perhaps my jaw. Steven's now watching Salt and Pepper. Good for you. Leo said, have you seen Howard the Duck? Not for a while, and I was not ready for it when I did see it. Revenge said, when are we getting RJ coffee? Let's see how the mugs sell first. We'll go from there. I'm not going to go all in and buy a farm in Colombia. Let's all relax. Steven said, which Doug though? Your fantasy name is Doug? Yeah, that's the fantasy. You don't want to say my name is Lothario. It's just too ridiculous. Something meek, something mild. Steven said, which Doug? Doug Henning, if anyone asks. Bill said, you could do a four-way eye for an eye match with just yourself, Marty, and Sammy, but you could add Columbo, Peter Falk, to the match as well. And then I'll beat him, and then he'll leave. He'll stop at the entrance, turn around, and go, oh, just one more thing. Ty said, putting himself in his own witness protection program. Neil said, say you're called Tarkin next time. That seems like fun. That's too ridiculous. No one's going to go for it. I want people to believe that I'm Doug. RJ, do you have a sore neck, or does your father, your impression of him looking up was rather yeah, I don't think it was a natural look in his movements. I'm gonna blame him. I don't have a I don't I don't think I think I can look up just fine. Ravang said he should have said Simone. Well, he didn't, and this is the world. As I spill some of this, it's not a big deal. We're getting it. Hunter said, if people ask for stupid names, I just put nothing. Their ass gets the full drink called out. Get owned. Well done, Hunter. That's why I chose Doug. I don't want to be like, my name's Batman. It's such a mockery of the system. I like to take it down from the inside. Jordan said, Simon Simeon sounds like a supervillain. Ah, the one who robbed us. Simon Simeon. Leo said, why do so many wrestlers follow and retweet Gary V? Because the holes in their hearts re require aggressive productivity and positivity. That's pretty much the only reason why. Now go kill it. Go fucking crush it. Neil said, Howard the Duck kissing scene was rather confusing. Yes, it was. Hunter said, they deserve no money, to be honest. My workaround before working there was buying $25 gift cards for $12 online. Now I just get whatever for free. Well done. Bill said, Stephen, great idea. Nail said, I don't have coffee today. It doesn't feel right. Why? Jason said, hey, RJ, it's 12:30 in the morning. Well, where are you? Val said, who the heck is Gary V? He's this like hip Tony Robbins guy. Who's tries to like motivate people to hustle and sell baseball cards and like just do it. I think he did a bunch of TED Talks, and he's like also a wine and sneaker salesman. There's a lot going on there. But I will tell you, if you've seen my motivational wrestling videos, they're pretty much a direct parody of him. Pole Girl Shine said, do ducks even have lips? It's a great question. I mean, it's a beak. Can you have lips on a beak? I guess is the question. Do birds have lips? Fish have lips. Horses have lips. Who else has a beak? Maybe they don't have lips. Unless you really consider a beak is in the lip category. I mean, I don't have a beak. I like when people say, somebody has a big nose, they say, oh, hey, this guy with this beak. And I'm like, that's not how a beak works at all. You should just say the person has a large nose. Oh, Jason said, I'm in Sydney. What's the spider situation there? Because someone was asking me earlier about if I want to go there, and I said no. Pantyless Grandma said, do you need lips to kiss? It's another good question. Can you kiss with a beak? You can kiss a bird. Can a bird kiss back? Huh. Neil said, do you have baseball cards? I do have baseball cards. I'm not interested in selling them. I have old wrestling cards too. And then for some reason, I have, and someone may also have these in the chat, so I won't feel too crazy, Desert Storm cards of people in the military, generals and shit, like Colin Powell, like real people. And I don't know why I have them. They're trading cards, and they're incredibly weird. Steven said, hip Tony Robbins guy. That shouldn't exist. Jason said, there's no such thing as a hip Tony Robbins. That's an oxymoron. Well, that tells you how fond of him I am. Pantelis Grandma said, fish also have teeth. Perfect kissing partner. Well, you don't necessarily need to have lips if you have teeth. You can have teeth and no lips. This is totally possible. Leo said, I saw John Stossel's YouTube page, and I hope he meets Dave Schultz again. I hope Andrew Schultz meets Dave Schultz. I was too scared to meet Dave Schultz. I was too intimidated. But I did get a copy of his book. The author hooked me up with a signed copy, and I was so happy. I was a big fan. Nell said, who else has a beak? Oh, is this a quote of me? Yeah. Donkey lips. Said Steve, do donkeys have lips? Lizard lips. Liver lips is what I'm thinking of. Do lizards have lips? Oh, Lord. Dissident99 said, any info on a match against Matt Cardona for that 10 bucks his fiance owns you? Tweet him and he'll agree to it. He seems to be agreeable. Donkey lips sounds like bad Erotica, Revenge Shed, Chromatica, or Art Pop? I like Art Pop. It's just fun. Hunter said, those are things. I've taken a ton of pop culture and war class, and I've never heard of Desert Storm trading cards. Steven said, Desert Storm cards. What movie was that in? Speaking of movies, I also have Adam's Family movie trading cards. Nell said, no one should be kissing in 2020. I agree. Jason said, the big spoilers are harmless but huge. The poisonous ones charge at you. Well, I'm out. Ugh, fucking shit. Do not like that at all. Bill said, RJ is the Steve Allen of advertising. For those that don't know, Steve Allen was one of the original TV personalities to do ads and was the first Tonight Show host. And who was a writer on that show? Steve Allen. And who was a page on that show in his first job in show business? Regis Philbin. Neil said, RJ would be great on the Shopping Channel. Donkey Lips is from Salute Your Shorts. That makes sense. Steven said, the great lip question of 2020. Jason said, check out Funnel Web Spiders on YouTube if you want to be horrified. I already am. I'm here. Don't need to do it. Aaron said, my stream has been frozen for a while, but I'm glad I made it back for the wildlife lip chat. Well, it's very important, and I'll be extracting this, and it'll be available on the National Geographic YouTube page. Hunter said, can you kiss in Canada if you kiss through a glory hole? No, because that's not glory. Then it's just the hole. The real glory is that your genitalia is involved. That makes the glory. Neil said, I'd like to meet a koala, but I don't want to meet the spiders. Fair enough. Lush Shadow said, goodbye, everyone. Y'all be safe. Leo said, RJ could be the AEW QVC champion. I would love that, and I would win the belt in 4 easy installments of $40. Neil said, Bill, yes, but he would say everything is an awful waste of money. That's fair. Steven said, I'd like to see RJ on What's My Line, which is also, the modern version was hosted by John O'Hurley. Zach said, when's your best friend Danhausen coming back? You may see him very, very soon, unfortunately. Jason said, glory holds it for Judith Light's fist holding bread. Jesus. Val said, also, I was told that a local joint is having 90s Nick trivia night and I want to go, but it's Wednesday night and it would interfere with Actor Dark and Limerick. Should I go? Yes, live your life. And then the next week, report back to me. It's okay, you have my blessing. Or just play me live in the place, and I'll answer the questions blindly. Hunter said, I almost studied abroad in Japan, and when I was learning about over there, certain regions have huge spiders that hide in your shoes and vents and stuff. I was horrified. Yeah, that's why you don't wear shoes. That's why I've stopped wearing shoes completely. Bill said, Steve Allen also gave Don Knotts a start, and Tom Poston. Steve also did wrestling announcing in 1949. We needed the good, the bad, the unknown on Steve Allen. Ooh, that would be great. I'm adding him to the list. Speaking of things that I have to do, horrible segue, I have more coffee to make. Oh, I didn't even get the so discombobulated. Here we go. See my bare feet? It's because of the spider shoe fiasco. Okay. One, two, three, four, and a little bit. Let's enjoy ourselves. Very nice. It is going to be a long weekend. I can wake up perhaps late tomorrow, and we're going to fill it with a little Avayan. Seems to be a socially acceptable water, and that's fine. It's a nice pour. It's a lighter sound than when you pour hot coffee. You know, I was thinking about the cold brew, and I thought, gee, when do you think I'll make hot coffee again? Because I'm so used to this right now because it is so hot. I'm like, when does it get cold? Maybe not until November, really. I know people say Canada is cold, and it certainly is when it does get cold, but it does stay hot for an extraordinary amount of time. Will you be doing a Wilfred Brimley retrospective on The Good, Bad, the Unknown? Probably not. I mean, at some point, I think. I have a lot of people to get through. This week is someone we just talked about today. Sometimes I like to do them logically. So I talked about Dom DeLuise, and he was in a lot of Mel Brooks movies. So I decided that this week would be Mel Brooks. So it comes out Friday, and my members get early access to it on Thursday. I hope you're all taking notes. Neil said, The Good, the Bad, the Unknown could one day expand to wrestlers' matches. That's for sure. Hunter said, RJ having no shoes on is fulfilling Charles' fantasy. Poe girl said, I missed your underwear shot. Well, in the spirit of being generous, they're this wonderful comic book pattern. And the nice thing about these is that they're not, this is the longest they are. I like to have them like here, to be honest with you. But this is great. If I need the extra length, if this area gets cold, I can just pull them down here. It's fantastic. It's comic book pattern. It's fun. It's hip. It's now. Leo said, when you're able to come to the UK, you need to wrestle in all the crap holes like Orpington and Bromley. Gee, I can't wait. Would you consider Tody Fields the good, the bad, the unknown? I would love to. She's a fascinating woman. Hunter said, the only socially acceptable water and also badass actress is Awkwafina, I guess. So this, do you like coffee with your butter? Yes, sometimes I take a stick of butter and I just drizzle the coffee on top. Neil said, if RJ was a character on BoJack Horseman, what animal would he be? I would have to be a cat. Anytime somebody draws me as a cat, it looks great. Actually, somebody drew a picture of me as a bird wearing that pink satin kimono robe thing, and I looked good also. A cat or a bird? Jack said, it gets cold in September. Do you remember? September. Val said, they're pretty strict on a no phones rule, but maybe I can pop in between rounds. Oh, that's fair. That's just tell them to put me on the TV. I'll put it in my Filofax. Yes, you will. Stokely said, sweet cheeks, RJ. Well, thank you. Eric wants them. They're Armani. They are not cheap. Bill said, Mel, hope you included High Anxiety, best movie of his. I didn't because I mentioned it in the Madeline Kahn episode, but I mentioned a few that I like. Also, High Anxiety has one of my favorite songs ever, and I love to sing it. It's a good crooning song. It's, I guess, the theme from High Anxiety. Yeah, I'm not telling you what I picked, but High Anxiety isn't it. Hunter said, crack is whack, crack is cheap. Whitney Houston. And Lou Albano once said, if you do drugs, you go to hell before you die. Val said, what I'm hearing is RJ looks good as any animal. Yeah, pretty much, but not a spider. Thank you. Hunter said, RJ as an RJ as an animal would be Michigan J. Frog. Bill said, next week I will have to sing High Anxiety. I would love to. I'm excited. It's one of my favorites. Leo said, Madeline Kahn. And that's a quote from Alicia Atoot, who had no idea who Madeline Kahn was when I brought her up. And then I yelled at her. Jason said, if you were a bird in a kimono, you could order chapstick from Amazon and ask them to put it on your bill. So happy you got that in, Jason. Very good. Hunter said, I don't think you've sang much today. I really haven't. Sing the Michigan J. Frog song. Hello, my baby. Hello, my honey. Hello, my ragtime gal. Send me a kiss by wire. Baby, my heart's on fire. If you refuse me, honey, you'll lose me. Then I'll be left alone. Oh, baby, telephone and tell me I'm your own. I think he also did the Michigan Rag. Everybody loves the Michigan Rag. But really, you know, Hello, my baby. Hello, my honey was the best. And that is a song I believe is public domain. I have to double check, but I believe it is. Leo said, is Tony Khan related to Madeline Khan? If he is, sign me up. Then if that's the case, I'm AEW bound for sure. Neil said, the side look, the smile, that's when a good one's coming. That, I had that just burgeoning deep inside me. Steven said, I'd rather Madeline Kahn to be interviewing wrestlers. Oh, I would love that so much. Stokely said, RJ did the horse. That's what matters most. Aaron put a frog and a top hat. Bill said, we will have to psychoanalyze your hatred for spiders to help you out. I have read about psychoanalyzing it. People get fearful of things that are so outside their comprehension. And something like a spider or something like an alien or whatever is so outside, is so unnatural, and unnatural meaning inhuman, and so as not how a human moves. It's so beyond my comprehension that's what frightens me. I'm staring the complexity of life in the face, and I just can't do it. Hunter said, I'm still reporting the stream for copyright just in case. You got me. You got my back, and I appreciate it. Panda's grandma said, why isn't there an emoji for an alien face hugger? They really should. Nell said, Hunter is hilarious. Jason said, she didn't know Madeline Kahn. She doesn't know the meaning of propriety. Hunter said, people are scared of spiders as innate survival mechanism from yesteryear. Also, they're fucking disgusting. Yeah, but then why do people like tigers? Riddle me that, Hunter, before you report me. Jason said, the spiders are only scared because of the jump scare. Not true. Nell said, I'm not scared of spiders, but I'm scared of crickets because they jump. They are a jumping spider. Steven said, can your next match just be a screening of Mixed Nuts? Yes, that's my Christmas show match. Eric just used the Hulk Hogan emoji without any context, and yet it makes so much sense. Missy said, I agree, Nails. I feel like it's Hunter's chat today, and good for him. This is our Hunter R tribute episode. Leo said, it's called a music blog. Yeah, with a question mark because all the bands interviewed are so bad. Yeah, it's questionable. Panzer's grandma said, because tigers don't have eight legs and a face full of also legs. What? Nail said, you should also look at Quokkas, and you will love quokkas. I don't like the flying grasshoppers, dragonflies. Hunter said, tigers are cute, but it's also not like I want to like hang out with one. I feel like if a tiger was on my shirt, I'd also scream and run. Fair. Ty said, people aren't scared of tigers because they can't hide in your ear canal like the spiders can. Yeah, I guess you never heard of a Japanese shoe tiger before. Hunter said, thanks. I'll be here all week, aka today and Wednesday. And speaking of, today is over. I want to thank everyone, the fine comic book pattern people, whoever designed these huckleberries, as I continue to do the horse. I'm not going to do the rest of it now with a coffee in my hand. It's been a hoot. It's been a time. And next week, I will sing my favorite song, High Anxiety. So let's get a nice final spin here. And until we meet again, Godspeed and God bless.